Last night we'll be talking about joyful church, and a prayerful church, and also thankful church. You know, so all the full, but make sure it's full of Holy Spirit, full of Jesus, and full of His Word, and full of all. Praise God! And so I introduce this team as I've already introduced, and make sure, don't worry about how many of us here, but we keep to the time. That's the most important. And so the Lord will lead every one of us, and last year we went together with Gabriel Elizabeth and another pastor to Santa Rosa, Philippines, and a church is called New Life. And so we have New Life Manila, New Life Santa Rosa, and there are 40 outreach work all over, and we only minister in one of the outreach conference they call Fire of God. I mean, you're a person. I took my first camp in one of the church in Faith City Church. Young people, you know, youth camp many, many years ago. And they give me the topic, Fire of God. Oh, yo. So, when you have a team like that, I did not eat for so many days, you know. How to bring down the fire? Don't play, you know. You have to pray, you know. So pray most of the time, did not eat. And young people, praise God. Actually, the Lord touched many. And one of the young ones that was touched was called Andrew. He was only 15 years old. Always come out hungry, pray. And today he's a youth pastor in Faith City Church. Another young girl who was touched went to Australia. He came back today serving, studying BCM and then serving as in a Chinese church. And so let's not underestimate God. Amen? The touch of God is so important. And so, I like to throw a different style, is it okay? Because, time is precious. So I'm going to preach on the Gospel of Matthew. And so we're going to flow very fast because Matthew present Jesus as King. So Jesus, and so we need to focus on Jesus. So whatever you and I do, make sure Jesus is the center of the church. Jesus is the center of our heart. And from this heart is so very important, you know why? Because the heart here is linked to heaven. That's why the song says, from our heart to heaven, Jesus is still the center, right? He's the center in heaven, He's the center in our heart, He's the center in this church. So New Life Restoration, the fire of God was there in 1 hour, 400 people were there. And they were great musicians. They can really worship, and they are really committed to the Lord. You know, some places you sing, but their heart is not singing. And so, but there, their heart singing, their spirit singing, and they came out with a new album, just launched out when they came to Taiping recently, and 13 of them. And so, we bought their first New Life Santa Rosa worship. But the title is called Heaven, Make Heaven Rejoice. Why make heaven rejoice? Because they want to see the precious fruit for the nation. And what's the precious fruit for the nation? It's soul, more people to be saved. And so that's a city here. It's just maybe more than 30. If the Lord touch your heart, you want to support them. I want to think about anybody who comes here. I see them carry books, I see them carry CD, I see them, sometimes the sale is only 5. I say, leave everything here, we buy all for you, and we'll carry for you. So they can go back to Philippines without the CD, they can read it. And so, if the Lord touch your heart, if you really want the CD, cannot afford, take it free. Somebody will pray for you. But if you see that you want, play it on. Seriously, play in your car. It's not as good as Planet Shaker. It's not as good as Hillsong, because they're all very profound. But this is also very profound. But the wording, the anointing is there. You play in your car, you play in a house, you know why? Because we have been there in the church. The fire of God came upon everybody. I mean, they are serious. I'm not joking. You ask Gabriel. We go behind also, you touch them, they'll fall. You go, every young fall, old fall, everybody start. I just say, receive the Holy Spirit. All the backup singer collapse all. And they don't, I mean, they are hungry and serious, you know. Because they have left everything behind. They have only Jesus. Amen? So it's just how I talk about this morning topic is called the touch of Jesus. The touch of Jesus is so very important. In Matthew chapter 8, verse 1 to 4, if you can have our wording here, it'll be great. I think this church has everything Bible here. And so Matthew chapter 8, there was a man with leprosy and he came to Jesus. He came. And he asked Jesus this question, if you are willing, please make me clean. If you're one suffering from leprosy, if you're one, in my early days, after I sat on every Logos for 2 years, I studied in Malaysian Bible Seminary for 2 years and went to Singapore Bible College, and I was with the Gospel Hall, the Brethren Church, and then suddenly when I came back in 84, I have to face a challenge that we have to, 15 of us have to just come out in Taiping, and we call ourselves the Full Gospel Assembly Taiping, and then link with Ipoh, and then came link with KL, and then it's all history. Since the church has started, I pioneered and pastored the church since 1984, 32 years, and there are so many other small outreach work in all the small town. And so praise God, it works. I remember the lecturer told me something, you know, when he charges in a student, he say, you go back, you must be faithful to the church. You must serve the church. You go back, you must be helping other ministry. And then I did not know why the lecturer is a bit funny, you know. I mean, the last part, he say, if no church wants you, you have no church to serve, you start a new church. I don't quite like the last part, you know, because I'm very sure I'm going back to serve. But I didn't know. I didn't have a church to serve. So what to do? With a group of 15 people, we launch out and praise God. God has helped us. And so in this passage here, the man with leprosy came to Jesus and he needs a touch. He said, if you're willing, make me clean. You may be seated here, you say, Lord, I have these needs and that needs. You are willing. You will supply for me. If you are willing, Lord, save me. If you are willing, strengthen me. And Jesus, of course, is always willing. As I said, in my early days, I was around in the street preaching to the drug addict and the gangster in Taiping. I don't know why, you know. Because I came back from the trip, I was so much love and compassion. And maybe God puts it that way because I was very teen, you know, that time. As teen, thinner than the dry addict. And they thought I was a dry addict. But many, many have been touched. And today they are either pastoring or they are serving in whatever way. We praise God for them. And today it's quite safe to go to Taiping because all these people have been transformed and changed. Last time it was not so safe. They have a word called extortion, huh? But now I don't know what. Huh? Or in Cantonese, it's Yao Sui Mo. It's not sway, you know. They want your money. I was also extorted by four youth pointing a knife on my belly and then flying kick behind. And I say, I know, I understand. And how come? Because you know why? I let them take everything. They want. And that time was only my salary, first salary to buy something for my father and mother. And I brought my girlfriend at that time, Penang. But she took everything from me. But I said, excuse me, can I have $10 more? Because I need to go home, I'm Penang. They give me. I said, cannot, alone, I come with two others, can another $10? So you must know all this, lad. They will give you one, don't worry. They won't send you empty. Then I said, just now the watch you take, it belongs to my girlfriend who give me, can I have it now? He gave me. I said, next time. Whoa, then they get angry, you know. Whoa, you ask so many, enough already. And they took my Bible, they took everything. I said, take, God bless you. You know, I came back a changed man. Not angry with anybody, but having the love for those who are in the street. And that was wonderful. Never mind, take the salary, at least I got $20 back and my watch back. I give away with the Bible. But I want to say this. This man with leprosy actually have no Jesus. There are many in the street do not have Jesus. So I pray that you will share with them the Jesus. And in this passage there, they came to Jesus and there was a touch of willingness. And Jesus touched the man with leprosy, the untouchable. And the moment the Bible says that he touched him, the leprosy disappeared. He was cleansed. There are a lot of people who are living with other kind of leprosy. Bondages to drugs, bondages to many sin. They need a touch of Jesus. I tell you, it's so glad to see so many change. But now I put on a bit weight, I don't look that dry. So I used to take them from Puduraya. I used to take I sleep in the Puduraya. Even as a pastor, I went to the center. That time we don't have center. And once I was slept overnight there, a group from Baptist Church, came and visit. I think they have been briefed to worship together. And then suddenly they will get into individual to talk to different drug addicts. And one came to me and was 14. He says, "Are you here new?" I said, "Yes, yesterday I was here." And so he said, "How was your withdrawal?" I said, "No withdrawal." Whoa. He said, "It must be a miracle." I said, "It's a miracle." Whoa, he looked at me. Huh? Whoa, so excited. And then he said, "How come no withdrawal?" I said, "I'm not a drug addict, I'm a pastor." Yo. I'm also a joker, right? Because he tried to have all the plan question already planned by his pastor, asked, "How's your withdrawal?" I say, "No withdrawal." He gets so excited. "Wow, we must be a miracle. Jesus," I say, "I'm not a drug addict, I'm a pastor, but I look like one." So important thing, the touch of willingness to Jesus as he touched the man with leprosy. Now turn to chapter 8, Matthew. Let's turn to chapter 9 now. There's a passage about a woman with the issue of blood. Verse 16 downwards. And what happened? That woman with the issue of blood. And she was suffering for 12 years. And she had blood sickness. You don't mind, I like to calm down a bit more. Is it okay, Pastor? Because I want to be down to earth. I'm not very comfortable sitting there. And so she was, she had been suffering for 12 years. But I want to just encourage pastor and preacher, but sometimes don't read too much into the passage, because a lot of time we try to be smarter. You must have this sickness. You don't know means don't know, lah. Huh? Sorry, chapter 8, verse 16. Sorry, chapter 8, verse 16. Sorry, my mistake. Matthew chapter 8, the woman with the issue of blood. I think 20, is it 16? Chapter 9, verse 16. Just now, what happened to the verse 17 to 20, okay? Chapter 9, just now. It's my mistake, not a mistake. I'm still not warm up yet. Chapter 20, verse 20. Just put it out, verse 20. Verse 20, Okay, thank you very much. So Matthew chapter 9, verse 20, that woman who had this problem for 12 years, and so he has a blood sickness, that's all. Don't try to say what kind of sickness. I don't know. The Bible only say blood sickness, issue of blood, that's all. But sometimes pastor likes to elaborate what sickness, I don't know. It's only a sickness that he had caused her that to spend all her money on doctors, and it was a painful sickness. She lived a penniless life and a pitiful sight. And what happened to her that she needs a touch? So she was just thinking, if I touch Jesus, I heard of Jesus. Brothers and sisters, the Lord put you in this church here so that you know Jesus, you are saved. And I like the way you worship, the way you put Christ as center. Maybe some of you are you need help. But you are very quietly sitting there. Your family need help. I went to Faith Covenant Church. I didn't know a mother was so sad there. And I was just sharing about testimony. One of the things that God has blessed my wife and I, it's the grace of God to open barren wombs. And we have seen 200 wombs open all over the world, and by the grace of God. And so this mother came out for prayer, and she said, "Pastor, my husband passed away. I'm so sad." And I said, "Why?" "My daughter married for 9 years, but she's not in the church. Can you please pray for her? Because we want her to have a baby. Is she okay or not?" I said, "Auntie, you just put your hand here. Receive the anointing of the Lord. That's all. I have no idea, because the daughter is never there, and I don't know who the daughter, but that was last year." And Pastor Joshua Lee was so excited. "Pastor, another miracle. The mother came out, you know what happened? And asked for the daughter, and the daughter conceived, and now the daughter had a baby daughter, just 4 days ago," he says to me. That was last month. Let me tell you, that's the touch of Jesus. As a woman went and touched Jesus' garment, hem of Jesus' garment, the Bible says immediately she was healed. That's a touch of faith. Earlier was a touch, chapter 8, verse 1 to 4, the leprosy was a touch of willingness, and now the touch of faith. But in the same very passage, that's why I always like this statement, you know. You know what that statement? To be at the right time, at the right place, with the right touch, or right blessing. Today you are here. The woman in that church was at the right time. Sometimes I just went back with my wife. I just thanked the Lord. And you know, everything I thanked the Lord, you know why? I say, what happened if the mother didn't ask for prayer? It would be 10 years problem. But because she asked, and she received. So today I want to encourage all of you. You are seated here. It's okay lah. Forget about whether you're Chinese or whether you're Asian. And we like to be Asian culture, Chinese culture. We like to have all this tradition. We are so shy when we are suffering quietly. But never lah. I learned from Pastor Daniel Ho recently in the page, Pastor Appreciation, and Pastor Derek Hong. Two of them combined to encourage the pastor. He says to Daniel Ho, you must preach Jesus Christ. He says we must be thick-skinned for Jesus. And then Derek Hong from Singapore said, we must be moving the spirit, thick skin for the Holy Spirit. So this morning I want all of us to be thick skin. I'm a very thick skin pastor. For Jesus. And all this team there, they are very thick skin. After they share, you'll be shocked. They're all very thick skin. Just look at the team here. Imagine, I don't understand how. How God can bring Penang, Ipoh, Melaka and Taiping all together, and there's only a few of us here. How God can do it, I cannot understand. It's all by His grace. And so the woman with the issue of blood had a touch of faith, and Jesus looked at her and said, your faith has healed you. And the leprosy, had a man with leprosy, has a touch of willingness from Jesus. And what about the other one? In chapter 9, there's a story, the same part there, the Jairus' daughter, who actually have a lovely daughter for 12 years. This woman suffered for 12 years, but this daughter have 12 blessings. But at the age of 12, and the father discovered that she's sick, you know. And then the Bible says she was sick and went to doctor, I believe, and she was not well, and she was at a point of dying. And this Jairus, the ruler, went and saw and looked back for Jesus' help, and Jesus walked towards the house. But before that, there was an interruption from woman issue of blood. You all know this story very well. You know what happened. But the news, bad news, you know, one thing about this, sometimes when we want to hear news, we hear bad news. And Jairus had bad news, and the person came to the house and said, it's already dead, your daughter. Too late, too late. Have you ever received any news like that? Too late. But Jesus still went to the place. And they were already mourning and said, and people were mocking, please, don't, he's already dead. And Jesus went out with the father, mother, the other disciple, three disciples, and went to the room and released a touch. And that's a very different touch, you know. Hold the hand of the daughter and raise the daughter from the dead. I want to encourage all of you here. I want to share sometimes, you have to excuse us because sometimes I share a bit of testimony. Humbly I share. You know, if I don't humbly, I don't share with you, then you don't know why our God is so good. I'm married to one wife and I have three children. Only one, huh? One day, my eldest son studied in Monash, and he called me, and he said, that was a few years ago, he said, Pa, I know this son, I got a daughter and a younger son. These two don't call for this, but this eldest one is very smart, always know how to fall. Pa, I need to fellowship. Can I have dinner with you? I know already, son, when I have dinner. So I was in SS2. I said, I'd like to go to the ice kacang store ABC. And so Pastor Gan was at a meeting, and we quickly rushed there. And Pastor Gan had to fetch others, you know. That's why Pastor Ron here says, no, Pastor Gan is a sweet spirit. And this son of mine, first question is, Pa, I need $500. That's why I don't like his call. And I don't have. Yeah, because pastor don't carry so much money on. Even the love gift I preach, I give away. But I don't have, you know. So I don't say I don't have. I say, wait, eat first, order your food first. I need an ice kacang. And then as I was ordering ice kacang, one lady wears shorts, you know. And he said, Pastor Bernard, nice to see you. I said, hey, auntie, you're here. He says, yeah, FGAK. I preach in FGAK. She's from FGAK. He said, Pastor Bernard, I just need your help. My daughter and daughter-in-law. I said, what happened? They couldn't come for your meeting. No, you see, okay or not? You pray for them to have baby. I have no time to check my Bible to okay to pray in ice kacang store. No, thank God I didn't check. No, I don't know. You see, she asked. I say, and people are walking up there, SS2 Taman Selera, and then we are ice kacang store. So a person asked, like the leprosy, if you're willing, let me clean, make me clean. No, that's all. So I say, okay, auntie, your two hands, right? Take your left hand and right hand. Receive it for your one for your son and for daughter-in-law, one for your daughter-in-law and son-in-law, and that's all. But at the same time, I'm also very careful, you know. No, I don't hold her after she fall down. Then you'll be in trouble, you know. That she didn't fall down. And then she said, thank you. I mean, Christian, make people happy, lah. I just make her happy and receive. So thank you. He said, wait, Pastor, haven't finished yet. Just now, I don't know why I come to this place. I also don't know why. And I went to the ATM machine. The ATM machine spoke to me, you know. He said, press $500. And I don't need the money. I don't know why I carry the $500. And so he said, Pastor, since I don't need it, I give it to you. Wow, my son saw it. My son said, there. I don't understand this, please. Don't try to bring a theology for that. I don't try to spiritualize that. I only know one thing. Receive it. And then the son answered the prayer. He ate so fast. And, oh, thank you. I gave it to him. You know what? What happened to these two? They have two children for the son-in-law and his daughter. They have two children or so. Now, two boys and one, I think it's one boy and girl. And the auntie is so happy, you know. Ever since I become his best pastor. When you are touched by Jesus, everything good become better and better become best. Amen? She's older than me, of course. But what I'm trying to share here, how can all these things happen? Not because of the man. It's because of the one above. And so, the touch of willingness in Matthew 8, the leprosy, the touch of faith for the woman with issue of blood, the touch of power by raising Lazarus' daughter from the dead. And later on, of course, there's the two blind men. Same thing. He asked you, Son of David, have mercy on us. And then Jesus asked them, well, you want to see? He said, of course. And then he put his hand on their eyes, and the Bible says, immediately their eyes opened. That was a touch of compassion, the touch of mercy. Today, I want to encourage all of you here, seated here. I'm not going to preach anymore. Because preaching got no result. Not so good now. Now is the time for you, as you are seated there. I just want you to do one thing, please. Forget about the speaker, but you can remember, only see his thigh. As Pastor Paul says that, I'm going to borrow from you, Pastor Paul, with your permission, okay? Can we shout Jesus 3 times? He come from him, not from me. Ready, 1, 2, go. Jesus! One more time. Jesus! One more time. Jesus! He came to Taipei, asked us to shout Jesus, or the pastor to shout Jesus, or no? And I don't know whether other pastors follow or more, but I follow or no? Whoa, I've been shouting Jesus everywhere. But now I shout louder because Pastor Paul from Korea is here. Let me encourage all of you here. In the feeding of the 5,000 in John 6, and in the raising of Lazarus in John 11. Soon I'm going to leave this place, going home, then prepare to go to Brisbane. And our topic in that church is miracles. How to receive miracle from the God of miracles. 6 sessions from Dr. Sim, press sessions, live ministry in Brisbane. Pray for us. I feel so weak, you know, honestly. Like how to preach miracles. But I want to tell you, when you are weak, you can be strong in Him. And so, Jesus looked at the multitude with the lima roti doi kan. And He gave thanks. The bread He gave thanks, He gave the disciples, they distribute. The fish He take it out, He gave thanks, and He distribute. I'll explain more in the second service. And then Lazarus was in the tomb in chapter 11. What happened? He was already dead inside there for a few days. And He looked up to heaven and He gave thanks. Father, I thank You that You hear my prayer, and I know You always hear my prayer. Then only He looked at the tomb, removed the stone. Lazarus, come forth. You say, Pastor, God was not there in the tomb. Pastor, God was not there when Jesus took the bread there, because physically not there. Maybe the man of leprosy, yes, he was there to touch the man with leprosy, the untouchable. Yes, with the woman with the issue of blood, he was there. Yes, because he touched his hem, the hem of Jesus' garment. For Jairus' daughter, he was there, physically there in the room, and Jesus held the hand. For the two blind men, yes, he was. There was a touch of willingness, the touch of faith, the touch of power, and there was a touch of compassion. But this one was not there, lima roti doi ikan, and this is not there. Why? Where? What touch are you talking? Let me tell you, that's the touch of heaven, the touch of supernatural. The daughter was not there when the mother asked for prayer. The other son and daughter-in-law and daughter-in-law and the other, I mean, daughter and son-in-law, they were not there in the ice kacang store. The touch on the left hand and the right hand, it was not a touch of a human, but that was a touch of heaven. And touch of heaven is a touch of miracle and a touch of supernatural, because our God is a God of heaven, a God of supernatural, a God of what? That will release His miracle. I think last year, my wife and I and this team was in Harvest Assembly by Pastor Allen of Klang, and his church is growing. A lot of people come out, we are excited, we pray. I was so encouraged, you know. But as I look at the couple there, I told my wife, I was shivering, you know. Because I said, whoever one baby, and this couple was waiting there. But they looked at Abraham and Sarah, you know. You're not shivering. They look like 80 and one is 75, one baby, you know. I quickly pushed my wife aside. I said, you go lah. She said, you go lah. I'm honest lah. Now you know my weakness. The way I can shout, I can talk. But I dare not go there. You know. I mean, the last couple, I was thinking finish, it close. I wanted to go off there. But they say, Pastor, come. I said, you go lah. But the rest very smart. All my people all finished praying their side. I went there. I said, I'm facing Abraham and Sarah now. I mean, I don't know, huh? And so we went there, and then we'll go there. Of course, we smile, we pretend to be very, very whole. I mean, sorry, we just smile. And hi, auntie, you want baby? No, we don't baby. Oh, yo, praise God. We show you the baby. Oh, yo, took out the laptop and said, last year you came, you prayed for my son in Australia, daughter-in-law. Now look at the baby, so cute. Because last year they stood in prophecy for the son. And the baby was given in Australia. I was so glad, you know, brought backward, you know. I know why. Thank God there was not Abraham and Sarah. You know. And I don't know about you, you know. Someone come out and say, Pastor, pray for me. I got no more womb. No, no, don't play one of these other things. You know. But I don't ask questions. I say, receive it in Jesus' name. Then I walk away quickly. You know. Why? If God is a God of heaven, God is a God of miracle. And God is a God of supernatural. In Matthew 19:26 says what? With God, all things are possible. In Mark 9:23, he says, if you believe, all things will be possible. In John 11:40, he says what? Yes, if you believe, Jesus told those who was outside Lazarus, the sisters especially, if you believe, you will see the glory of God. This morning, I pray, whatever problems you're facing, whatever pain you're going through, whatever perplexity, I want to share this to encourage you. You know why? I just sometimes, all my theology in Singapore Bible College, all my studies, I cannot even apply it. I say, now the latest is what? The latest is all non-Christian calling to the phone, because I went to that church, another couple stood there, very well dressed up, I think like working in the, a professional. They came early, and her name is Rachel. And husband, he said, Pastor, can you? I heard you can pray for people to have baby, but I want to tell you one thing: can your God give baby to me? I'm not a Christian, you know. You see, there's a theological question, you know, but I'm not going to bother, you know, honestly. I told you because I saw it everywhere. I said, of course. So we pray for her, and she listened to a message in Easter Sunday in Klang. And after the service, she stood there again. He said, Pastor, can you pray one more time? Since you are not Christian, we need two-time prayer. Okay, lah. My work is only to pray. If they ask, I pray. Lah. See, please, when people ask you to pray, don't walk away. Lah, please, don't say cannot. Lah. Just pray. Lah. I pray. And she went back. The following month, she called, Pastor, conceive already, you know. And she, after that, now the whole family came back to church, you know, father, mother, and all, and they were all baptized, so happy. Let's give a big clap to the Lord together. And not only that, she started to introduce to all her friends. She said, Pastor, I'm so happy. You remember, if this sister call you, my non-Christian call you, this one call you, please, my friend, respond to them, they're all non-Christian. I learned one thing, you know. For Jesus, he can release a touch of love, the touch of willingness, the touch of honor, the touch of faith, the touch of power, a touch of compassion. But with God, it's a touch of heaven. He touched to save the person. He touched to release his signs and wonder. And so this morning, I just want you to just think of this time and see the word Jesus. And I want you to be seated here. As you are seated here, let him touch you one more time. That non-Christian friend, I never fear. I say, you believe, receive it, and also conceive. And one day another two came to my church. Three daughters, you know, one Christian brought the sister and the nieces. And I forgot about everything because I know they are not Christian. He said, pray, I pray, pray. And that prayer meeting last week, he said, Pastor, pray for my niece, you know. And that niece was so excited. Now one of them, the thin one, Pastor said, the thin one conceived first and the fat one later on. I don't know why I say that, you know. I don't know thin or fat. But I said, yes, you say that. And the reconceived one and one still waiting. They are not believers, you know. They're not Christian. And so right now, whatever you are seated on, if God can bless the unbelievers, those in the world, how much more all of you who are so faithfully worshiping, serving Him in whatever situation. Amen? It should show that He's a God. You need the grace of God. But let me tell you, you need the miracle of God. You need the supernatural of God. But let me tell you, above the grace of God, the power of God, the miracle of God, the supernatural of God, we have the God of all grace. We have the God of all miracle, the God of all supernatural, the God of the Bible. Come to Him. Now I call upon Evangelist Gabriel. And I want to also acknowledge one thing, please. It's not God that always use the pastor. No. Sometimes I pray, people are not healed. Sometimes I pray, but other people pray, God healed. So it's to tell you, He can use anybody. Amen? He used the pastor, He used the member, He used all of you. I call Evangelist Gabriel now. He's going to move in the word of the Lord. You don't know him, he don't know you. He's going to call you out as a Lord lead. All these things will be done within 15 minutes. So that's why you need a touch, a quick, suddenly, immediately, powerful supernatural.